नमस्ते वन एंड ऑल एंड इंडिविजुअल्स इन रेस्पेक्टिव डोमेन्स. इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वाज गिविंग माय एग्जांपल एज अ पार्ट ऑफ रेफरेंस एज टू हाउ आई ओवरकेम द स्ट्रेस स्ट्रेन एंजाइटी डिप्रेशन एंड other aspects. Now let me talk about what could be the reasons for an individual to get into the state of anxiety, stress, strain, and psychological and mental disorders. And other depression, etc. As an individual, where exactly an individual fails. Now, let's try getting into the core fact of understanding basic human psyche. When the human being or individual is born, he or she is born with nothing. Till the age of 3 or 4, he will not have stress, strain, or whatever it is. But the moment he or she attains 4 or 5, that's when the strain, mental stress, disorders, etc., etc., start evolving in an individual. For some people, there are certain disorders like gender dysphoria, special cases like gender dysphoria or psyche, psychotic nature. If we really see all of these cases, these are not disorders. In fact, these have the practical relevance to the in and around the society or the social moving. How exactly the household environment, etc., is all about. In fact, to tell you honestly, I suffered with gender dysphoria or gender variations, because in and around my atmosphere I always used to see my own people used to compare me with, she is doing good, why you are not able to do it? She is doing something great, why you are not able to do that? She is having that elegance, she is having that, she is having this, she has that innate capacity, she has this, she has that. Now what happens is, the moment this comparison starts, this starts developing into your subconscious mind, and this is where the gender diaspora starts. And the individual who is hearing to all of this starts thinking that, oh, maybe if I was she, I can get this. In fact, that is what has had happened. But I realized it very late when I came to 30 or 34 years that I am committing mistake, but it was too late for me. But still I overcame that using the dance and music, art and culture, spirituality, philosophy, understanding human psyche, human psychology. Ever since my childhood, I always used to have a strange feeling that feminine form is a very beautiful form. If feminine form is beautiful, can I be into feminine kind of thing? Unfortunately, to share this, there was nobody to really educate me on this, that beauty does not lie in whether you are masculine or feminine form. This again comes with the family cult or the family, you know, traditions. If this is being taught to them, this is what comes to the parents also, right? Because they would have also come from the same age, from the same lineage. Today, if I really look at all kinds of lifestyles of the youngsters below 30 or below 25, they get used to all kinds of habits and they have the strange feeling that having money, having name, having power, having accolades, etc., etc., is very important for everyone, for an individual to really grow in his or her life. And it is a social status. Unfortunately, this is one of the gravest mistake and greatest mistake that all of us are doing. And in fact, this is what is taught in classical dance form, talking about the inner beauty, understanding the inner beauty, understanding the inner self, and trying to explore over that. That is the real beauty, rather than the external beauty. Very famous line from Lalita Sahasranama, Antar Bahisya Samarajya Bahirmukha Sudurlabha, which talks about this. Now, why am I talking about this? Why one should have clarity of the inner beauty than the external beauty? Inner beauty is all about understanding yourself, your inner engineering, how exactly your thoughts are traveling. And this is what is understood via yoga. Yoga being traveling between space and time. And today yoga practitioners or yoga teachers, whomsoever I see, they talk about subjects other than the one which I am talking about. So this is where the difference is lying. Even for a dance teacher, when the dance teacher is teaching, it is a primal responsibility for a dance teacher to make the students understand what is the inner beauty, what is the inner self, and then teach them the steps. Steps are the mediators that help an individual to take control over your panchendriyas, panchakoshas and shat chakras. When it comes to non-dancing professional, when he or she learns yoga or meditation, what is it that he or she is learning out of it? Is it a mere meditation that he is doing? Today I have pyramid, Reiki, etc., 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 which talks about the energy levels. How these energy levels are activated, what these energy levels are, are to be understood in depth, in the deeper aspect. And this is what is being taught in Yoga Kundalini, which is a different subject altogether. Now, let me give you a brief glimpse about this. Like, I have seen foreigners talking about it by and large with regards to planetary motions, and they were explaining it in their own terms. Unfortunately, that is like misleading the people. And this is the saddest part, that we are not able to understand about it. The point is, I'm getting forced to talk about this because I have come across live examples. I'm seeing live examples where an individual is suffering from anxiety, depression, and various other ailments. And he or she takes antidepressant tablets, which are of no avail at first place. Naturopathy is the best. I am telling this because I have suffered from this for quite a long time. Today I am 45 and my journey in art and culture, that is understanding the classical dance form or the classical music, yoga philosophy, and the spirituality behind yoga and meditation for almost close to 25 years now has been a very significant journey for me. Tattva Shastra, Mantra Shastra, Tantra Shastra, Tantra by way of performing yajnas, homas. I had a very different experience altogether during my Sabarimalais intervention, wherein I went for almost like 18 years. The point is, I have been practicing all of this. I have had apathies. I have had all kinds of issues, and I do have issues even right now. But then, the stress and strain, anxiety, depression and all, I am able to handle that. Even that gender diaspora also, I am able to handle that to the best level. What is it that has changed me? What is it that really is one thing that has affected my psyche or psychosis part, leading to the psychological development, the psychological evolvement within myself. I see my surroundings taking tablets for all kinds of ailments. Why? What is that one difference between them and me? I am working naturally, understanding who am I, what am I, why am I, what is the purpose, what is the end goal, what is the end result. With no expectations again. We have to understand this part, friends. It's for one and all. Today, when I was watching one of the videos in dance forum, quite a few dance forum, and people talking about what is it that needs to be done to overcome this, asking a legendary dancer about the same. Maybe he had convinced her because he never wanted to, discourage them, but he gave in a very sweet terms. But this harsh ground reality is to be understood by every individual, from the dancing fraternity, music fraternity, individuals in other domains, and artists, cinema artists, dance drama artists. They are suffering from that pandemic attack. They don't have any shows. Shows are closed. What next? What needs to be done? I know an individual who is suffering from anxiety, depression and all. And he is taking tablets and he got used to the tablets. Now he cannot come out of it. Sushant Singh Rajput, who was taking antidepressant tablets for quite a long time, committed suicide. Other girl from TikTok, or I don't know her name, I forgot her name. She committed suicide. She was 16 years. Divya Bharati, taking antidepressant tablets. Why antidepressant tablets are needed? What is it that happens when you take antidepressant tablets or anxiety tablets or whatever it is? Some kind of chemical reactions start happening. I am sharing this because I took those tablets as a part of experimentation for quite some time. Maybe 2 months, maybe 20 days, in fact, 20 days I took. Under the neuropsychiatrist who diagnosed me as BPID and ADHD and etc. etc. He was giving his own crap reasons, some bullshit reasons, but he never understood what exactly needed to be done. And he never took time to even talk, etc., etc. Of course, in my environment also, nobody really wanted to talk to me about these matters, specific matters. But they wanted to talk upon some useless topics, which is the mistake that everyone does with his or her kids. This is where we falter, ladies and gentlemen. And this is where art and cultural forms, classical dance, plays a key role. It helps you to understand your mind, who am I, what is my purpose, etc. It clears your clutter of thoughts that come into your mind. But point is, you need to learn it from this point of view, not from the entertainment point of view only. You need to understand this part also. This is what is called therapeutic part. It's not so easy to explain to kids, but indirectly by teaching them steps and all, they will come to learn, they will come to know about it in the later stages. Yoga, travel of mind between space and time. Are we really doing that diligently? Or are we just doing it for the sake of doing that asana or whatever it is? Is one point which one needs to understand. And meditation. What is meditation? Is meditation all about sitting for 20 minutes or 30 minutes or 1 hour or 2 hours? No. Even for 5 minutes, if you sit and do the meditation, that's enough. You have to look into your inhale and exhale and see where it is traveling, to what notes it is traveling. Maybe yes, you may ask, have you ever experienced? Yes, I have experienced, and that is the reason why I am talking about it today. This anxiety, depression, etc., etc. And special cases like gender diaspora, that also needs to be addressed. In today's generation, in the 21st century, I was seeing, sorry about that, some of the cases where a male was telling, I had that thinking, I had that thought right from my childhood. How did that develop? As a part of case study, I was just looking at that statement. Is that the environment that he or she was into? And that is what made him think about the gender diaspora? Yes, I was also the same. I also had it. But why is it not working for me? But it is working for them. Question is, the thought process channelization is very important. For that, parents are responsible. In my case, I only had to take the initiative and work towards that closely for 10 years with all sorts of meditations or yoga practices and all. Nobody really taught me about this. I was a self-learner. I have been a self-learner. Even the classical dance form, to understand that step, what is it that happens? What is the phenomena? What is the structure? What is the purpose of this step? I only had to do research. If I had asked few of the professional dancers who were having experience, no one could answer that question. Whatever questions that I was asking. And in fact, I was befooled. Fooled for that. I was laughed at it. Why this situation has come? What is it that really matters for an individual to really understand in and out of our culture, Vedic and Upanishad culture specifically? This is one line that divides an individual, friends, into one and all. And this is what is the baseline for Natya Shastra. Natya Shastra is not all about the 36 chapters that it is talking about, Angikam, Vachikam and all. It's way beyond that. And Natya Shastra is all about understanding how the Panchakoshas, Panchakleshas and Panchabhutas can be controlled. The very base reason for Natya Shastra to be produced is to show the society directly that if you practice this way, if you try to understand the base level study of all of these and practice it, you will be able to overcome anxiety, stress, strain, depression, gender diaspora and other ailments, because it touches upon Prakriti and Purusha, masculine and feminine form. In short, there has to be someone who can explain this very specific concept. This is a very important concept that needed to be explained to the aspiring dancer or to the aspiring musician from the viewpoint of Shat Chakras, how the energy levels travel from Mooladhara to Sahasrara and above. We are having 7 chakras that are being predominantly explained, but there are 12 chakras which needs to be understood, and this needs to be done in a chronological order. This is what I have understood in my experience of learning or understanding. I would say, rather put it like understanding classical dance form or the dance form or the music form as a whole. Yoga, how a body travels between space and time, what really happens during this period of time where he or she need not take any tablets for antidepressant, depression, anxiety, stress, strain, and other things. And special ailments like gender dyspora and all can be taken care of when you understand the Tattva Shastra as a whole. Now, how is this to be taught for a non-professional? It is a parent's responsibility to understand and teach his or her kids in their own language. Which is what was missing in my case. I wanted to share this with one and all because I had to explain this. Emergency situation has come. And the situation has come for everyone to understand this to the core level. Or else, as an individual, whether he or she would not be able to handle the delicate situations or critical situations like this pandemic attack. Today, due to the pandemic attack, not only dancers, musicians, I'm not talking about established dancers and established musicians, but I'm talking about someone who is learning and someone who thinks that is his bread and butter, has to understand from this point of view as well. To get over that anxiety, stress, strain, depression and other things. It could be any field. There is this emergency situation and situation wherein one needs to be taught, one needs to understand this. Friends, it's high time, specifically for art and cultural format, individuals in all the domains to understand yoga, these being pointers and factors of the video. Yoga being the body travel of between space and time. Maya and Mahamaya, Yoga Maya, Yoga Kundalini, Kundalini, these may be like higher terms, but these needed to be understood by one and all. And this is what is called Tattva Shastra or Tathya Shastra, in depth and to the core. I wanted to share this with everyone. Please do take care of yourself. Stay safe. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with all. Have a nice day ahead.